I'm proud to say that I've been with Aimia now for more than 10 years, and it's been and continues to be an exciting and rewarding time to be in the evolving loyalty industry. I'd like to start off today by telling you about a meeting I had with a potential investor just a couple of weeks ago, during which I was asked, why did you choose to globalize and expand beyond Aeroplan? So let's start with the fact that Canada represents only 6 billion of the estimated 100 billion global loyalty market. Moreover, from the very earliest days, we saw that loyalty had global application. It is ubiquitous and is understood around the world, regardless of language or culture. Loyalty fits perfectly within the context of think global and act local. It can be mirrored across different geographies, yet it's customizable by market. Loyalty has all of the characteristics of a global business, including scalable technology, intellectual capital, and commercial partners and suppliers. Despite having these global attributes, the loyalty industry remains quite fragmented, and it's our intent to lead the consolidation and to own the loyalty space. I should mention as well that globalization was critical in order to diversify our business away from the Air Canada risk. Aeroplan was vulnerable on its own, and we absolutely needed other assets with muscle to protect this core business. As a result of our successful growth strategy, we emerged from the most recent Air Canada liquidity situation just a couple of years ago much more favorably than we would have if we had just had the one asset. Aimia's management team is incentivized on long-term success and value creation. Accordingly, we've aligned our vision and our strategic objectives with a clear two-prong approach to maximizing shareholder value. The first prong is focused on deploying capital to fund organic growth in our strong core operations and to invest in high-return new businesses. The second prong focuses on returning value to shareholders through dividends and buying back our common shares when appropriate. Our approach to value creation has been successful thus far. We delivered a compounded annual rate of return of 18% over the last 3 years as we continue to make significant progress towards achieving our global vision. In the 10 short years since we became a separate entity, Aimia has grown into a significantly cash-generative, multinational company with a robust platform for growth. With our full suite of services, we are leaders in the global loyalty industry. Aimia is at the forefront when it comes to coalition loyalty, retail data analytics, and has a growing and significant presence in white labeling and outsourcing other companies' proprietary loyalty programs. We're following the roadmap, which we set out early on, and we're making investments that we expect will generate high returns for years to come. Now, other companies may have similar ambitions. However, we're convinced that Aimia is the only one that is successfully achieving the global vision right now. In keeping with the spirit of today's theme of creating value for shareholders, I'm going to talk briefly about our capital allocation policy and the process. Following this, I'll share with you how we value our portfolio of investments and assets. In terms of capital allocation, we complete a rigorous examination and valuation of all of our potential investments. Part of our review involves benchmarking any investment against, of course, the return of buying back our shares. And only then do we select the investments that we believe will best contribute to Aimia's long-term success and increase shareholder value in the long term. Recall that I said a few moments ago that Aimia's management team is incentivized on the long-term success of the corporation. Indeed, a large proportion of our compensation is delivered in equity or equity equivalents with a multi-year vesting tied to our three-year plan. This, combined with minimum shareholding requirements for executives, ensures that when we think about spending an incremental dollar towards expansion or growth initiatives, we think about the return profile of that $1 over a minimum of a three-year time horizon. And if you take vesting into account, it actually is a little longer than that. So in terms of how we value our assets, let's start with the acquisition of the Loyalty Management Group at the end of 2007, since that was the first major step that we took towards achieving our global vision. With the purchase of LMG, we gained three important assets and accomplished several key strategic objectives. Firstly, we significantly extended and increased the potential magnitude of Aimia's free cash flow generation capability. It reduced our reliance on the Aeroplan program and its commercial partners, and it's allowed for the cross-fertilization of ideas, of innovation and expertise between the teams at Aeroplan and Nectar in the UK. Next, we increased our retail data analytics bench strength through the acquisition of a startup operation, Intelligent Shopper Solutions, which is now a world-class business. Data is at the heart of loyalty, and it's growing in importance very rapidly. You will hear the Aimia team talk a lot today about the power and the value of data to our future. Finally, through our purchase of LMG, Aimia became a coalition loyalty powerhouse. With the acquisition of Nectar UK, the largest and most successful European loyalty program, and the addition of a team with extensive experience and expertise in launching high-return greenfield programs, such as Nectar Italia, this is one strength which our competitors still struggle with as they attempt to catch up with Aimia. The UK and Italian Nectar coalitions have solid footings in their respective markets. Each is on an upward growth trajectory and is increasing its contribution to adjusted EBITDA and free cash flow. And in fact, in the case of Nectar Italia, after only 30 months, it's generated more free cash flow than it took to launch the program back in 2010. I should highlight at this point that the cost to launch Nectar Italia was substantially lower than the startup costs of Nectar UK. And that's primarily due to the scalability and portability of our technology platform, which we'll continue to leverage as we launch additional coalitions around the world in the years to come. In order to understand the value creation of a retail-based Nectar program relative to a frequent flyer coalition, you can't simply look at it on the basis of the margin profile. To allow for the fact that an airline-based program requires a greater upfront investment, it uses significantly more ongoing capital, the valuation metric that we use is return on capital employed. And if you apply that metric to a mature Nectar program, the outcome will yield a return that is very well into the double digits. With respect to the combined assets that we have today as a result of the LMG acquisition, namely two Nectar programs and ISS, the return on capital is improving and is expected to hit double digits in the next 2 to 3 years. The return will improve as we benefit from both organic growth and operating leverage, and as we unlock additional value through initiatives such as our new JV with Sainsbury's, which we announced just this morning. You'll hear more about that JV, by the way, later on, of course. Each of these businesses is still far from being a mature asset, and each has the potential to generate considerably more free cash flow in the coming years. In order to achieve our global vision, we knew that we needed to provide the full suite of loyalty services, and this meant expanding into proprietary loyalty. Accordingly, we acquired Carlson Marketing, experts with a long proven track record. To value this acquisition, there are several things you need to consider. One, proprietary loyalty represents 2/3 of the loyalty market globally, and we didn't have access to that at all prior to the acquisition of Carlson Marketing. Two, having the ability to offer that full suite of services increases our addressable market to include the entire $100 billion of global wallet. And finally, the acquisition of Carlson Marketing increased our decision sciences capability. It added to our proficiency in the mobile and digital loyalty space, and it greatly expanded our geographic breadth, including a critical presence in the US, the world's largest loyalty market. So despite the challenges that our US business is facing at the moment, our proprietary loyalty operations in Canada and Asia Pacific are doing really well. The assets we acquired in the Carlson Marketing transaction are playing a critical role in helping us achieve our strategic objectives and our global vision. So notwithstanding some of the bumps along the way, and particularly the difficult US economic environment right now, our rate of return on Carlson Marketing acquisition is good, and we're actually a little ahead of where we thought we would be at this time on a total basis, and that's primarily due to significant synergy savings with our existing business. That said, similar to LMG, Carlson Marketing was a transformational acquisition, which we expect will contribute significantly to Aimia's free cash flow and value creation over the long run. This will come as the business grows and transitions to provide more value-added services, such as data analytics, which in turn will obviously result in a larger market share, in margin expansion, and a higher return on capital. But you will not see us expanding into some low-end commodity businesses such as blast email marketing, mass couponing, mailing list management, etc. And we see some of our competitors going that way, but we don't believe that that's a smart move. Of course, The degree of improvement in our proprietary business will depend on the extent of growth in our operations in Canada and the Asia-Pacific region and is correlated directly to the recovery of the economy in the United States. U.S. and Asia-Pac are pursuing several exciting avenues for growth. Over the next several years, our focus will be on growing proprietary services and launching high-return coalition loyalty programs in both the U.S. and in the Asia-Pacific regions, where no one is better positioned to succeed than we are. Along the way, we may make strategic acquisitions that will augment certain aspects of a proprietary business. So the most recent example of that is our acquisition of Excellence in Motivation, which you will hear more about today. One of our key objectives in rolling out our global strategy has been to replicate the Aeroplan business in other markets. After talking to many airlines, including Qantas, Varig, and even TAM in the early stages of the MultiPlus company, we finally found Club Premier. It has all of the attributes to be a successful coalition program. It's got a great management team and a board, and this is very important, that is focused on creating shareholder value. And frankly, we also got a little lucky. Shortly after we made the initial investment, Aeromexico's largest competitor, Mexicana, effectively went out of business. So Aeromexico became the dominant carrier, particularly in the business segment in the region, and that was extremely helpful. Over the past 2 years, we've worked very closely with the Club Premier team to impart our knowledge and to embed Aeroplan's technology and capabilities into the business. The extremely positive results that you've seen so far clearly underscore our unique ability to develop, to build, and then monetize value in frequent flyer-based programs. Obviously, we're very pleased with Club Premier's exceptional performance to date, so much so that we have initiated discussions with Aeromexico with the intent to increase our equity participation. I think that most of you would agree that our investment in Club Premier is not included in Aimia's current valuation in the market. Accordingly, we expanded our disclosure about Club Premier a couple of quarters ago, and I hope that will help you understand what the value of that business is. In addition, I'd like to highlight a couple of points. The first is our intent for Club Premier to be the 2.0 version of Aeroplan. It's obviously going to be slightly smaller because of the different geographic and demographic characteristics of the Mexican market, but that is where we're taking the program. The construct of Club Premier is similar to Aeroplan in terms of the margin profile and the free cash flow generation. And lastly, we believe that Club Premier has the potential to be a real home run in terms of return on investment. And I'm pleased to say that Jeremy Rabe, the CEO of Club Premier, has returned for his second Aimia Investor Day, and will update you on this fast-growing program a little later in the agenda. Let's now focus on the hidden value of some of our earlier stage investments, starting with Cardlytics. With its outstanding technology, which you'll actually have the chance to see firsthand today, our investment in Cardlytics keeps us ahead of the loyalty curve and represents our first opportunity to create value through a non-currency loyalty program. At the most simple level, Cardlytics is the US leader in transaction-driven marketing. Its platform enables merchants to provide targeted offers based on previous purchasing behavior illustrated through the electronic banking statement. Our investment in Cardlytics includes a 10-year commercial agreement, which gives us the right to sell and distribute Cardlytics' merchant-funded transaction offering outside of the US. We believe that Cardlytics will be rewarded with a high valuation as it successfully rolls out its platform. Scott Grimes, the CEO of Cardlytics, is also here today to tell you about how the company is already working with some of America's largest national retailers and financial institutions, such as Bank of America. I can guarantee that many of you who walked in here today, not really understanding Cardlytics' business, will leave very impressed with what you hear and have a much better view of its overall value to Aimia. Last but not least, I'd like to address how we're unlocking value in emerging markets and at the same time reducing our risk by co-investing with local leaders. In Brazil, as you know, we formed a joint venture with MultiPlus to create an innovative new loyalty marketing services company in Brazil. We're very excited about this new venture. It gives us access to a population of 192 million people and one of the world's fastest growing economies. Brazil is ranked sixth largest by nominal GDP. As part of the JV, we'll bring our expertise in proprietary loyalty and data analytics to the table. In exchange, Multiplus will provide Aimia with relatively low-risk market access, with established commercial relationships, and critically with local knowledge of how to operate in the Brazilian market. Collectively, we'll be involved in the continuous support of the business with a focus on building and transforming the loyalty marketed services industry in Brazil. The JV will be run by Maurizio Quinze, and he's moved over from his position as Chief Commercial Officer at Multiplus into the JV. Now that we have all of the requisite regulatory approvals in place, Maurizio is scouting talent to build the local management team, and it's our expectation that this business will be up and running in the first half of 2013. Our entry into India, where we partnered with the Tata Group, marks another key milestone in our execution of our global strategy. India's GDP is expected to grow at an annualized average of 8%, making it potentially the world's fastest growing major economy from now way through until 2050. In addition to launching a coalition program, there may be travel-based opportunities as well as the Indian market matures. However, it's important to note that we do feel that it's going to be slower to market in India than in some of the other economies in which we operate. It's a very complex place to do business, and consumer retailing is still relatively immature, given the small but growing middle class as a proportion of the total population of 1.2 billion. With respect to some other emerging markets, this afternoon you'll hear from the team about Indonesia, where we just agreed to make a small investment to increase our ownership in a company called Interact. Carlson Marketing has owned an equity stake in that company since the year 2000. Interact is the leader in Indonesia's rapidly emerging loyalty sector and has a very solid portfolio of blue chip clients, which include Nestle and Mazda. In terms of our approach to value creation, here's where I foresee things heading in the coming years. We will exploit our full suite offering and expertise to be the undisputed leader globally in loyalty. Data analytics will assume a greater role in the execution of our strategy and in the contribution to our financial results. We believe that data analytics has the potential to significantly elevate Aimia's value and role in the marketplace. Next, I foresee that the Canadian business will make significant moves to increase its penetration of the $6 billion domestic loyalty market. In addition, our Nectar programs in the UK and Italy will continue to sign on new major partners. They'll benefit from operating leverage and become materially more cash generative as they each strive to reach maturity and achieve returns that are very well into the double digits. We expect that our US business will grow as we leverage our loyalty expertise and technology in this market and as particularly the US economy recovers, on the assumption that it does. Our Asia Pacific business will continue to expand as we introduce the full suite offering in this diverse and growing region. When I think about the next 5 years, we'll absolutely be pursuing opportunities to invest in other frequent flyer-based programs. However, I do want to caution you that while there remains some really good opportunities out there to do so, they really are scarce. Also, we'll continue to leverage our technology platform and launch additional Greenfield Coalition programs. I'd be very surprised if in the next 5 years, if we haven't launched several new programs, including one in the US. Last but not least, I believe that we'll be materially more advanced in emerging markets by 2015. In terms of capital allocation, we will continue to evaluate the return profile of every dollar we spend as we review investments in areas such as decision sciences, data analytics, and of course, mobile, as the world moves towards the digital wallet. We don't have any aspiration to actually own the e-wallet. However, we do expect to play a pivotal role in its success. Our strategic objectives are focused on long-term growth. The benefits will be seen in the value we create, namely increases in free cash flow per share and value growth in shareholder return over the years to come. Now, you'll hear more about value creation throughout the day from many of the key members of Aimia's executive management team who are here with us today. Next up, we have Dave Adams. Most of you know Dave. He has been Executive Vice President and CFO of AMEA for 5 years now. Dave will give a financial overview and provide details on several topical subjects. Following Dave, you'll hear from Vince Timpano, the President and CEO of our Canadian operations, and from some of his team members, including Kevin O'Brien and Michael O'Sullivan. We'll then have a short break, and then we'll hear from David Johnston, the President and CEO of EMEA. David is joined by Jan-Peter Lips and Pete Gleason. After lunch, Liz Graham, our COO globally and our President of the US and Asia Pacific regions, will talk about the prospects for growth that she sees in both of those geographies. Liz will also be joined by several members of her team, including Jay Lee, Fei Boshin, and Carl Schuster. By the way, I'm pleased to say that Bob Miller, the CEO of EIM, is here with us today in the audience. As I mentioned, we're honored to have two special guests with us here today, Jeremy of Club Premier and Scott Grimes of Cardlytics. Their presentations will close off AMEA's fourth annual Investor Day on an exciting note. We really hope that you enjoy the day. For those of you who are here in person, please do acquaint yourself with our management team and feel free to ask lots of questions during our Q&A sessions. And we also welcome those of you who are listening on the webcast and invite you to send in your questions.